Hello, comic book fans. Here's Earl Grey. Today I want to talk about Annihilator, drawn by Fraser Irving and written by Grant Morrison, put out by Legendary. This is a nice hardcover with all the six issues that were published. And it's one of Grant Morrison's more accessible stories. This doesn't mean that is not one of his weird ones. Grant Morrison's maybe always a bit weird, as you know. But yeah, this story is understandable, comprehensible with the first read, I guess. Especially when you cheat a bit and read these character pitches from Morrison in the end, about the main characters, their intentions and all that stuff. Contains maybe minor spoilers, but I would think it's a good recommendation to start with this, maybe read an issue and then this back matter part delivers some explanations that you don't get so easily from the text. What it's all about? We have Max Nomex here, who is sort of an artist, rebel, criminal a bit, who rebels against the order of things in the future. There's a computer controlling everything with his police, and this is one of these policemen, so to speak, the Annihilators. The Annihilator is the term for the black hole in the middle of our galaxy as well. And that's a picture, a metaphor, which turns up all the way through the story about nihilism and black mass and nothingness, so to speak. For example, we have here a black hole in the garden of the new house of Ray Spess, or Ray Space, spelled S-P-A-S-S, like the German Spaß, fun, but there's nothing fun about or funny about this character. He's a bit grim guy, always open for big excesses with prostitutes and stuff like that to keep his creative juices flowing. He wrote that future story here around Max Nomex. Max Nomex, that name is telling as well, because this guy is there and he's not there. He's on the edge of creation, so to speak. It turns round a bit the other way in the end, without saying too much. The story develops further and further into bigger scales towards some sort of creation myth. Fraser Irving's art is very expressive. His facial expressions often border on caricatures. Yeah, I found it peculiar because 2 weeks ago I dissed sort of Andrea Sorrentino's art for being too heavy relying on computers and photography and all that means. And in Andrea Sorrentino's art, I don't like this too much, this aspect of his art. Fraser Irving's art, the opposite, I do like. Maybe because he goes some steps further than Sorrentino. He is really eager to experiment, to do stuff with a computer and not just as substitute for real drawing, but just to do things you can't do so easily with pencil, or you just can't do with traditional pencil work and watercolor and whatnot. So here we, especially for this panel, we have a picture in the back with sketches for that panel, and that's clearly done on the computer screen. But that's pretty obvious that this art here by Fraser Irving just can be done with a computer aid. And it's pretty amazing, I must say, including the colors, which were his own work, of course. So, some panels are really interesting. And we have this weird little teddy bear who plays a certain role in the story. And all the story is very well contained, and we can hope there's an volume 2. Max No Max will return in The Devil's Walk, but it's left in the unclear if this refers to the comic or maybe to a future Hollywood movie which could be written by maybe Ray Space, but I don't want to say no more to avoid unnecessary spoilers. So, Annihilator by Legendary and Morrison and Irving. Great book if you're into sci-fi, dark sci-fi with a twist. And I forgot to mention one factor that clearly helps to keep this stuff here comprehensible is that Morrison kept his cast of characters very overseeable. There are just 3, 4, 5 main characters, and they interact with each other, and that's it. So that helps. Very typical for Grant Morrison, I guess, is this fake history of this Max No Max character. He pretended that Max No Max would have been around for a century or so in old Fumetti and stuff like that. But there is no Fumetti, no Italian comic with No Max. It's a bit like Fantomal or Diabolic or something like that. And of course, Fraser Irving had to do these these would have been covers for these comics, including some sequences, which is pretty neat as well. So you get a lot for your bucks, I think, and a beautiful book. A nice story with some twists in it. What do you want more from a comic? So, thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.